This is going to be one for my new friend from Asia, Mas Jabrik. He's doing the most fantastic stuff with glue-ups, and I let myself be inspired by him, and I made one of myself. These are two pieces of hardwood, and as you see, they are so much above the surface that I have to plane them smooth first. I have a new toy for that. Let's see how that works. Next we take this baby to the bandsaw. mounted the ball on a faceplate ring. So that's how I put it on my SE3. I'm really eager to start turning on this ball, and above all I would like to see how this difference in wood pans out, because this is hardwood, it's really rock hard, and the rest is relatively soft. That can be problematic. I've sharpened my gouge, we'll just start and see how it turns out. That was 240 grit, and it feels very nice actually. Time to put on some sanding sealer, I guess. Very nice. One of the things I have made, I don't know how long ago, is this. Let me zoom out. This protective cage for spray painting. And I think this is going to be the first time ever that I will be using it. Well, how's that? I think I'm very well protected now. and some glittery silver. I'll leave it at this for now. You see that hole here? That's the center of my Forstner bit. That's how thin the bottom now has become. can hear how thin that is. So sanding time. It's amazing how such a tiny black dot in the middle can draw your eye. But I will put on a first coat of sanding sealer on the inside, and then we will see what we can do about that hole. The sanding sealer is sort of dry, so we'll start our repair attempt. First of all, I'll put a piece of tape over the hole on this side. And I'll take off the lid. And you can clearly see where it has gone through. I think I have about 3 millimeters. I went to the bandsaw for a bit of sawdust in the right color, and that's what you see in that jar over there. After that has dried, I can sand it, and it will be as invisible as possible. Well, when I did the spray painting, I guess I was a bit too desperate to get rid of the hole in the center. So I overdid it with the silver, and yeah, as you can see, the result is that I had to sand it back. not 100% perfect, but for what I have in mind, I don't think that will be a big deal, because I've decided once again to call in the help of Mother Nature. What I've done is I've collected a few leaves. There are plenty on the ground. It's winter now, so you don't have to look long. Put a small piece of double stick tape so that it does not fly away when the paint blows by. And three. And then I will again take my gold spray paint, because I wanted to use gold on the inside instead of silver. This way you can also see a bit of the contrasting wood colors in the bottom. So we'll let this dry, and then we'll see how it looks.